It is Newsday, BBC World Service, Alan Kasuja and Claire McDonnell. Now, let's talk about a key impact of the spread of coronavirus on people's lives. One has been the inability to freely express their faith with others, with churches and other places of worship around the world having to close because of social distancing. Worshippers have had to find other ways to connect with their religion, and this has led one priest to think about how he could help city dwellers in London, where he lives. Reverend Pat Allerton has been holding 10-minute services on the streets of the capital and specifically outside hospitals every day since places of worship have been closed. He does this with a loudspeaker and a hymn and a prayer. Delighted to say he joins us now. Welcome to Newsday.
Thank you so much. Good morning.
It's great to have you on. Now, it's such a, obviously a crucial weekend. Lots of people will have had to worship at home. So you're ahead of the curve on this one. How did the idea come to you?
Well, the idea came as soon as I knew that people couldn't go to church. I simply thought, well, what if church went to the people? And so I just simply had the idea, well, what if I allowed speaker system and played a hymn and a prayer? You know, and I recognise not everyone has faith. Certainly not everyone's Christian. So you have to do it delicately and tell people who you are, that you're not going to be long. And hopefully it'll just be a beautiful piece of music, even if they don't share the deeper aspects of the faith connected with it. So, yeah, that's where the idea came from a couple of weeks ago.
And where did you, which locations, how did you select your locations?
Well, I'm a parish vicar, a priest in Notting Hill. So initially, I was just planning to go to the streets of my parish. So I started on the Portobello Road. I used to be known as the Portobello Priest on Instagram, but the media recoined that the Portable Priest as I've gone to other streets round and about and indeed a few hospitals.
And what kind of reaction have you had? Because presumably the streets are pretty deserted. How do you know that? How are people reacting to you?
Well, you see a lot of little faces appear at windows, so it's quite fun, actually. And I obviously encourage people only to come to their windows or doorways and socially distance. And I distance myself. Originally, I was in my car. Now I just go on a tricycle. It's part of my daily exercise. I've got a generator, so I'm fully independent, can set up wherever I want. But the reaction's been wonderful, actually. I've been very surprised. At first, I didn't know whether it'd be rotten tomatoes. But actually, it was a ripple of applause. So that was very pleasing. And I think people are just... Yeah, they're just delighted to join in a communal moment where, you know, we can't really do that at the moment. So at the very least, it's lifting spirits. But more than that, I hope it's giving people a bit of hope, as I speak of and point to with the song Amazing Grace, the God who loves us. And, of course, Easter sent his son to die and rise again for us. Jesus is alive and can transform anyone's life.
And I know, to talk about the hymn Amazing Grace for a moment, you have been doing this outside hospitals as well. You've had some incredible feedback from doing it outside hospitals, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, it's been amazing. Can I read you one quote?
Please do.
From a hospital. So I went to Charing Cross and we did it outside there. And you don't know if anyone can hear because it's such a big building and all the windows are shut. But then I found this message a week later in my Facebook inbox. It said, "Hello, I'm not a religious person, but I wanted to thank you for what you did on Thursday night outside Charing Cross Hospital. My uncle was in there at the time and passed away alone the following morning due to coronavirus. Knowing he could have heard this song on his last night on this planet brings tears to my eyes and warmth to my heart. Thank you from the bottom of my heart." And that was one message, and another message came from a nurse who was similarly treating a patient who was fighting the virus and later died of it. And she said the peace it brought her and that patient, she'll never forget. So, yeah, that's the reason that I'm doing this, and we'll continue
to do
it, I hope.
We thank you for that, and we thank you for talking to us on Newsday, Reverend Pat Allerton. From myself and Alan, thank you.